Everyone, welcome to the Vintage Narrative on our first adventure into the first episode of the original Twilight Zone series. We're going to be watching the pilot episode. It's called Where Is Everybody? And it's from 1959. And let's check it out.
There is a fifth dimension beyond that which is known to man. This is the dimension of imagination. It is an area which we call the Twilight Zone.
Oh yeah, jazzin'. First off, what's he wearing? Is he a mechanic? That looks like a jumpsuit. Hey, Papa.
Say, I noticed there's a town just up the road. What's the name of it?
That's incredibly rude. I don't think that would fly today. I don't think anyone's back there. How are you going, breaking stuff? That guy just broke their clock.
Eggs over easy. Hash browns.
Yeah, just make yourself at home.
You got a customer out here.
If anyone was there, I wouldn't be surprised if they denied you service, sir.
I'm a cash customer.
Oh, okay.
I got $2.85, American money. But I got $2.85 and I'm hungry. That much is established.
Wait, he just changed their sign to closed? Who's ringing that bell? There's gotta be someone there. It always is pretty eerie when there's nobody on the street. Is that just a refrigerator? If he's hungry, I see some food in the window right there.
Hey, miss? Miss, over here!
Something tells me she's not gonna say anything back.
Well, don't you think I'm nuts or anything? It's nothing like that. It's just that I don't seem to remember who I am. Look, I really don't want you to be frightened or anything, but I was wondering if there's a doctor or...
Who put that mannequin in that car? That's what I want to know.
I'm terribly sorry, madam. I can assure you that at no time did I mean to be so upsetting.
At least he apologized. Oh, so the mannequins go in the front seat. Not the back. Yeah, you can talk to those ladies, too. That place looks familiar. I wonder who called.
Please make sure that you have the right number.
Operator. Operator, will you listen to me, please?
This is the special operator.
So even back then, people were annoyed with automated operator, services.
Operator, look, all I want to know is where I am.
Not a working number.
Look, please, can you...
Please make sure that you have...
Great gag.
Oh no, that's nightmare fuel.
How about a hand, somebody? A little assistance, how about it?
He definitely likes to talk a lot, that's for sure.
I wish I could shake that crazy feeling of being watched.
Wait, you feel like you're being watched, but... Well, I guess, you know, a phone rang and the teapot went off and... Yeah, I can see why you feel that way.
Calling all cars, unknown man walking around police station.
You can get a lot of trouble for impersonating an officer. I'm really glad we don't smoke indoors anymore. That can't be good for the water bill. Get out. Get out. You don't have the key either.
Hey! Where
Whoa, that's the name of the episode, dude. This guy's just really hungry. I think if he could eat something, he'd probably feel a lot better.
I'm sorry, old buddy. I don't recollect the name. The face is vaguely familiar, but the name escapes me. This whole bloody town, wherever it is, whatever it is.
It's Oakwood. I saw it on the
phone book. I just remembered something. Scrooge said it. You remember Scrooge, old buddy? Ebenezer Scrooge? You see, that's what you are. You're what I had for dinner last night.
It's all about food with this guy.
If I can't wake up, at least I'd like to find somebody to talk to.
Uh-oh. Is he the last man on Earth? Dude, you need to pick up solitaire. It's a lot better. Maybe he'll get some popcorn. Might make him happy. That's all he seems to care about. It was this big.
Air Force, I'm Air Force.
So he's an Air Force mechanic.
Air Force, I'm in the Air Force. I'm in the Air Force. Hey, I'm in the Air Force. Hey, everybody, I'm in the Air Force.
I mean, if I had a nickel for every time I yelled that into an empty theater.
That must have been it, a bomb.
I don't think he'd be the last man on Earth.
Who's running the pictures? Who's up there? Who's in here?
Whoa, that was cool. That must have hurt. Almost expected another, where is everybody? Careful, dude. I'm not sure how running would solve anything. Might even make it worse.
Help me. Help me, help
I think it's
me,
safe to walk.
Help me, help me.
You can help walk.
Me, please, somebody help me.
Can you help me? Somebody's watching me. Help me, please. Help me, help me, help me.
Oh, he's being watched.
Help me, help me.
Is this the CIA?
Help me. Help me. Help me. Help me.
Get him out of there.
Help me.
Quick.
Help me, help me.
Release the subject on the double.
Go break in more clocks, man. Hey, well, at least now you can get some eggs, maybe.
Be careful, Colonel. Don't cut his hand. The glass on the clock is broken.
I can see that, Sergeant.
Colonel's like, it's not me, dude. He did this.
All right, Colonel. Go. He's all right, sir. Delusions, I think. He's coming out of it now.
Fine.
Did you get a timing on him?
484 hours, 36 minutes.
Good.
Well, the press, sir.
Oh, yes. On the run, gentlemen. If you don't mind, I want to see Sergeant first. The man was confined alone in a box for something in the neighborhood of 484 hours. That's roughly equivalent to a trip to the moon, several orbits, and return.
Why did this turn into a press conference?
What happened to him is that he cracked. But let me tell you all something, gentlemen. If any one of you were confined in a box 5 feet square for 2.5 weeks, I'll give you especially good odds that your imagination would run away with you, too.
Well, fair enough.
Excuse me.
Excuse.
What was it like, Ferris? What did you think you were?
A place I don't want to go again, sir. A town.
Oakwood.
A town without people, without anybody.
You see, we can feed the stomach with concentrates. We can supply microfilm for reading, recreation, even movies of a sort. We can pump oxygen in and waste material out. But there's one thing we can't simulate.
You mean my poop?
That's a very basic need. Man's hunger for companionship.
Next time it won't be just a box and a hanger, will it?
No, Mike. Next time you'll really be alone.
Are you really gonna send him still? I don't know if he can handle it. He should have to do it at least 3 more times. Those are some big doors.
Hey.
Hey.
Don't go away up there. We'll be up there in a little while.
Up there. Up there in the vastness of space, in the void that is sky. After this word from our alternate sponsor, Kimberly Clark.
Yeah, good way to start the series, I'd say. Definitely a bit of overacting, but must be pretty hard to do when you're the only person they're filming. Yeah, that's cool. Psychological. It wasn't any real sort of monster. Just had you guessing the whole time. Pretty cool. Well, I hope you enjoyed that too. See you again next time for episode 2. All right, till then.